This is The Unseen Wife, Barren Pines, Book 2, written by Kate Bold, read by Scarlett. Chapter 1. Sweat beads at my brow, the humidity in the room clinging to every pore, but I don't let it show. I tighten my grip on the handlebars, lean forward just a fraction more, and pedal with a fervor that's echoed by the 20 pairs of legs that churn in unison around me. The air is thick with determination and the musky scent of exertion. Come on, ladies, up that hill. Push, push, push. My voice carries over the pulsating beat of the latest chart topper blaring through the speakers. It's a command, a challenge, a rallying cry all at once. They need to believe they can conquer their limits, and it's my job to take them there. I glance over the sea of bobbing heads. Ponytails flicker like whips as we simulate the steep incline. Their faces are flushed, the strain evident in the crease of their brows, the grim set of their mouths. But no one stops. No one gives in. They're here for transformation, for the burn, for the sweet agony of release that comes from pushing past what they thought possible. And I am their guide. A bead of sweat slides down my spine, a reminder that I'm not just an observer, I'm part of this struggle. Every sinew in my leg muscles screams for respite, yet I answer with silent defiance. If I relent, even for a breath, then what example does that set? No, I have to be relentless, tireless. Keep going, you've got this, I shout. Louder now to drown out the whisper of fatigue nipping at my own resolve. I imagine each pedal stroke as a step away from my ex-husband, Daniel, and his condescending sneer, a revolution toward reclaiming my self-worth. With each turn, I'm cycling further from the woman who was defined by her husband's status, and closer to the one who defines herself. Thighs burning, lungs heaving, I watch them push themselves, riding their own personal tsunamis of effort and determination. But amid the chorus of gasps and the symphony of spinning wheels, I spot something off key. The rhythm falters. One of the bikes slows its tempo. Keep it up, you're doing great, I call out, but my eyes are fixed on Sophia. Her pedal strokes become labored, her face a canvas of distress painted with beads of sweat. She's always been the steadfast one, pushing through every session without a word of complaint. A silent warrior in our midst. But not today. Today, she is faltering. I ease off my bike, my heart still hammering against my chest, and make my way to hers. Sophia? My voice softens, laced with concern. You okay? She looks up at me, her breaths shallow and quick. I'm fine, she insists, but her pallor tells a different story, an untold narrative of discomfort and strain. I place a gentle hand on her shoulder, grounding her, reminding her that it's okay to rest. Take a moment, I urge. Listen to your body. Sophia nods, offering a weak smile as she eases off the pedals. There's a collective sigh of relief from the group, as if they've all been holding their breath, waiting for permission to acknowledge their own fatigue. I glance at the clock on the wall. The big hand hits 12, and the hour is ours no longer. Time has slipped away from us, a thief in the guise of adrenaline and endorphins. All right, everyone, I announce, raising my voice to reclaim their attention. That's time. You've outdone yourselves today. I beam at the room, pride swelling in my chest. Amazing work, ladies. There's a cacophony of relieved groans and laughter as they begin to slow their pace, the hum of the machines winding down like the afterglow of a storm. They dismount from their bikes, legs shaky but spirits lifted, victorious in their efforts. Remember, I say, as they start to collect their water bottles and towels, it's not about perfection. It's about showing up and giving it everything you've got. And you did just that. I catch Sophia's eye and nod to her, a silent commendation. She managed to listen to her limits. That takes as much strength as pushing through them.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.